the connectivity between the hemispheres were stronger in the Arabic-speaking people. This highlights the importance of the meaning associations in the Arabic language.
In our study, we included 47 German native speakers and 47 Arabic native speakers. Then we asked all the participants attend the diffusion MRI scanning. And based on such data, we can build the structural network in each participant's brain.
We were interested how the brain changes during development and learning. So we knew from our developmental studies, when we looked at children growing up, that the brain changes and adapts to the language that we learn. And the better we learn the language, the stronger gets the connectivity in the brain. For starting from this, we were interested in these two questions, like first, like how is the brain changing while learning a second language as an adult? And is the connectivity in the brain influenced by the learned language that we learned during lifetime while we grew up? Does the mother tongue leaves traces in the brain and is specific to every language? And this was why we thought like we should compare two languages which are very different, like German and Arabic, and look at the brain connectivity between people who learned German as a mother tongue and people who learned Arabic as a mother tongue, and compare their connectivity in the brain to see if the specificity of each language, so the difficulty in each language, is reflected by a specifically strong connection in each of the languages. The study was also triggered by the situation that we have a large immigration from people from Syria to Germany in 2015-16, and those people didn't know German before and they wanted to learn German, and so this was also a reason why we chose this population and studied Arabic, since we just had the possibility to get them easily involved in this study and in the same time also get them involved in this language learning course.
اللي استفدته أنا من الدراسة إنه كانت ساعدتني بلش بدراستي في الجامعة وإنه لاقي هالعمل، فكانت هي الخطوة الأولى هون في حياتي في ألمانيا. يعني أي واحد بده يعيش في بلد جديد لازم يتعلم اللغة الجديدة، وبتعلم لغة عم تعلم أنت كمان العادات والتقاليد تبعهم.
طبعاً تعلم اللغة اللي هو هيئنا وأهلنا لأنه نفوت لسوق العمل ولأنه ندرس بجامعات ألمانية، بس رقم اثنين أنا بتخذ التجربة بشكل عام كمثال رائع حتى لموضوع الاندماج، لأنه جابونا لهون استغلوا اللي فينا اللي هو أدمغتنا، وكانوا بدهم يخوضوا معنا تجربة علمية، ونحن بنفس الوقت استغلينا اللي عندهم وتعلمنا منهم لغة، فكانت يعني صفقة رابحة بصراحة. ورقم اثنين النتائج المذهلة اللي طلعت بالبحث.
We have a really interesting result. This is in the German native speaker, we found that in the regions and the subnetworks were related to the complex syntax processing shows a stronger connectivity than Arabic native speaker. In the Arabic native speaker, we found that the connections between the regions were related to the semantic processing shows stronger connectivity than German native speaker. And interestingly, we found that for the Arabic native speaker, the inter-hemisphere connectivity also shows stronger than German native speaker. So our study can suggested that our brain can shape by the native languages we speak.
I would expect that many new labs got aware now of this difference in the brain, that not all brains are the same. So previous research started with from the hypothesis of a universal language network, which I also agree, so the basic structure of the language processing is the same in all languages, but we have these modulations. And if we now do a specific experiment in a certain language, we might find certain activations specific to this language, and those might not be the same in the different languages. But differences is not meaning that one is better than the other. It's just different languages process different tasks differently. I think the next step would be to look how the brain changes during the learning, and how the different steps of learning changes the brain. And of course, I wish all the best for our German learning participants, for their life here in Germany, with their very good language progress they made here in Germany, and that they can use this to perfectly integrate in this German society with their newly learned language.
يلي عجبني باللغة الألمانية أنا إنه الواحد ممكن يحط الكلمات وراء بعضها يعني وبيشكل كلمة جديدة، فلذلك الواحد ما أنه مضطر يحفظ كلمات جديدة. مثال على هالشي أيا شالن زول بروخ شتيرن فوزخة، هاي كلمة بتدل على اختراع ألماني لتقشير البيض.
Wir Menschen waren, sind und bleiben für immer unterschiedlich. Entweder sehen wir das als Vorteil oder einfach als Nachteil.